This is the Voice of America transmitter, WLWO.
Unsere Stimmen kommen zu Ihnen aus New York.
This is a voice speaking from America.
A voice from America at war.
Our voices are coming to you from New York, across the Atlantic Ocean to London, from where they are relayed to you in Germany.
Today, America has been at war for 79 days.
Daily at this time, we shall speak to you about America and the war. The news may be good or bad. We shall tell you the truth.
It is now 13 hours Greenwich Mean Time.
This is the Voice of America, Washington, D.C., signing on.
Today we tell about the history of radio and the latest technology.
Here is the news in Special English. I'm Jim Tedder in Washington. Former Russian President Boris Yeltsin has died. Russian medical officials say the cause was heart failure. The former leader was 76. Mr. Yeltsin was the first president of Russia elected by popular vote.
Time for jazz. Willis Conover in Washington, D.C.
This is the Voice of America. Washington, ba-ba-ba-zip. D.C.
This week in the United States. Here is a review of the past 7 days in the United States. Your reporter, Rhett Turner.
The new era in international communications drew two continents closer together this week as the United States and Europe transmitted special television programs to each other through the Telstar television satellite now orbiting the Earth.
Welcome to the National Voice of America Museum of Broadcasting. From 1944 through 1994, six of the most powerful shortwave transmitters in the world broadcast to listeners seeking truth in Europe, Africa, and South America. Every week, millions heard programs in 50 different languages beamed globally from this hilltop. The facility, called Bethany Station, occupied a 1 square mile area. When you visit, you will learn why these broadcasts prompted the despots of the Second World War to call Cincinnatians liars.
I'm Avi Arditi with Roseanne Skirbel, and this week on Wordmaster, we explore the origins of two terms that listeners have recently asked us about, Big Apple and Kangaroo Court.
Wisdom teeth are normally the last teeth to appear. This usually happens when people are in their late teen years or early 20s. In other words, when they are older and wiser.
Many people believe Henry Ford invented the automobile. But Henry Ford did not start to build his first car until 1896. That was 11 years after two Germans, Gottlieb Daimler and Carl Benz, developed the first gasoline-powered automobile.
Welcome to This is America in VOA Special English. I'm Steve Ember.
And I'm Faith Lapidus. Today, we tell about some of the foods that Americans like best, America's favorites.
You may have heard that Americans like hot dogs and hamburgers best of all foods.
but people whose favorites are pizza and apple pie would give the meat lovers a spirited argument.
While aboard the recovery vessel Noah, Colonel Glenn received personal congratulations from President Kennedy. Here by recording is a portion of their telephone conversation.
Hello?
Hello, sir?
Colonel?
This is Colonel Glenn.
Oh, listen, Colonel, we're really proud of you, and I must say you did a wonderful job.
Thanks, Mr. President.
Well, we're glad you get down in very good shape. I was just watching your father and mother on television, and they seemed very happy.
Well, it was a wonderful trip. It's almost unbelievable to think back on it right now, but it was really tremendous.
Well, we're going to we'll see you over at...
I'm Fritzi Bodenheimer.
And I'm Mario Ritter. This week on our program, we hear about fathers who cook for their families. Then we look at the spread of food trucks in American cities.
English. I'm Steve Ember. On October 22nd, 1962, President Kennedy made an announcement to the American people.
This government, as promised, has maintained the closest surveillance of the Soviet military buildup on the island of Cuba. Within the past week, unmistakable evidence has established the fact that a series of offensive missile sites is now in preparation on that imprisoned island. The purpose of these bases can be none other than to provide a nuclear strike capability against the Western Hemisphere. Upon receiving the first preliminary hard information of this nature, last Tuesday morning at 9 a.m., I directed that our surveillance be stepped up. And having now confirmed and completed our evaluation of the evidence and our decision on a course of action, this government feels obliged to report this new crisis to you in fullest detail.
Kennedy had a warning for the Soviets.
It shall be the policy of this nation to regard any nuclear missile launched from Cuba against any nation in the Western Hemisphere as an attack by the Soviet Union on the United States, requiring a full retaliatory response upon the Soviet Union.
Welcome to This is America in VOA Special English. I'm Barbara Klein.
And I'm Steve Ember. This week, we tell about the history of one of the most popular and colorful toy products in America. Generations of American children have grown up coloring and drawing with crayons made by the Crayola Company. These small sticks of color are also popular around the world.
This is VOA correspondent Rhett Turner at Cape Kennedy, Florida. Standing about 5 kilometers from the point where a Saturn V rocket stands bathed in a wreath of brilliant light. Atop the rocket, inside the Apollo spacecraft, named Columbia, after Jules Verne's spacecraft, are the first men who will attempt to land on the moon. The beaches, fields, and highways surrounding the Kennedy Space Center bustle with people, an estimated crowd of several hundred thousand, seeking the best vantage points to witness the launch of the astronauts. Their mood is tense and expectant.
Now pressurized, 35 seconds and counting. We are still go with Apollo 11.
Many have slept on the beach or in their cars, bundled up against the chilling dampness of the subtropical night.
T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence starts. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. All engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11.
As the astronauts go where man...
In the last phase of its march, moves now slowly over to the Lincoln Memorial, across Arlington Memorial Bridge, to the Arlington National Cemetery, the final resting place of President Kennedy. Perhaps at this time we should remind you that this is the Voice of America in Washington, with a special worldwide broadcast of the final rites for the late President of the United States, John Fitzgerald Kennedy.
Welcome to the Voice of America in Albanian.
Ju flet zëri i Amerikës, më mbrëmat.
This is the Voice of America station at Rhodes, bringing to a close this portion of today's broadcast. For specific information concerning the time and frequencies of these Voice of America English language programs, write to Program Schedules, Voice of America, Washington, D.C., USA, or write to the United States Information Service Office nearest you. Now, this is the Voice of America station at Rhodes, concluding this portion of today's broadcast.
This week on our program, we look at the history of root beer. Most Americans know it only as a soft drink, enjoyed by generations of children and adults. Yet root beer played a part in shaping the modern food and beverage industry. It even launched the Marriott hotels around the world.
Root beer is a sweet drink similar to birch beer, but popular mostly in North America. Different versions can be made from at least 30 choices of ingredients. These include sassafras, vanilla, wintergreen, cherry tree bark, licorice root, black cherry, and cane sugar. Brewers who make root beer can also use
music and more. VOA Europe up next. Parker's picks at the flicks. This week, the new Patrick Swayze, Point Break. You'll get the review next, right here on VOA Europe. Heading to the movies with me this week, and opening today in the United States, Point Break, starring, and check out this cast, please, Patrick Swayze, Keanu Reeves, and Gary Busey. When you hear guys like that in a movie, you figure this is going to be a hot one.
This is the Voice of America, Washington, D.C., signing off.
Those of you now tuned to 9.585 megahertz are listening to the end of an era in broadcasting.
September 1944 was a long time ago. World War II was raging into its sixth year. And on the 23rd day of September 1944, the Voice of America officially dedicated six new transmitters built by the Crosley Company. The transmitters began service at the VOA relay station in Bethany, Ohio, in the American Midwest. Bill Connolly, the current chief at the Bethany station, says the Crosleys performed far beyond anyone's expectations.
Normally, you would anticipate a lifespan on a high-frequency shortwave transmitter to be about 20 to 25 years, and we have now exceeded that by twice. So I think that's a testimony to the creativity and the engineering skills of the Crosley people to build a transmitter that could be operated this long.
A few moments from now, when the clock strikes 6 hours GMT, the long and productive life of those Crosley transmitters will come to an end. In just a few seconds, Ralph Woods, one of the original electrical engineers from Crosley, will throw a switch, and the tubes of the mighty Crosley transmitter will go dead forever. But in the memories of shortwave enthusiasts, those fine old transmitters will resonate for years to come.
This is the Voice of America, Washington, D.C., signing off.